Welcome to two examples of improper integrals, where we have discontinuous integrands on the interval of integration. Let's begin with a quick review. Remember, there are two types of improper integrals. The first type is when the interval of integration is an infinite interval, or when we have an upper or lower limit of integration of either negative infinity or positive infinity, or in some cases, both. And we can see in this case, we write these integrals as the limits of integrals as seen here. But for our two examples, our improper integrals have discontinuous integrands on the interval of integration, which means our function f of x will be either discontinuous at a, the lower limit of integration, or at b, the upper limit of integration. So if the integrand is discontinuous at a, the lower limit of integration, we can write the integral as the limit as c approaches a from the right side or positive side of the integral from c to b. And if f of x is discontinuous at b, the upper limit of integration, we can write the integral as a limit as c approaches b from the left side or negative side of the integral from a to c. The third case is when our function f of x is discontinuous at c, which is inside the interval from a to b, which we can write as two separate integrals, and then write these integrals using limits. And these types of improper integrals can be a little more difficult to identify. So going back to our first example, notice how our function here would be undefined or discontinuous at x equals 0. We can verify this by looking at the graph, as we see here. So we're going to write this integral as a limit as c approaches 0 from the positive side or right side of the integral from c to 6. So we'll have the limit as c approaches 0 from the positive side or right side of the integral from c to 6. I'm going to go ahead and write this as x to the power of negative 0.8. So we can apply the power rule of integration. So now we'll integrate this and then find the limit. So we'll have the limit as c approaches 0 from the right. Applying the power rule of integration, we would have x to the power of negative 0.8 plus 1. That would be x to the power of 0.2 divided by 0.2. And our lower limit of integration is c. The upper limit of integration is 6. From here, notice how we have 0.2 in the denominator, which is 2/10 or 1/5. So we have x to the 0.2 divided by 1/5, which is the same as multiplying by the reciprocal of 5. So we can go ahead and write this as the limit as c approaches 0 from the right of 5x to the power of 0.2. So we have the limit as c approaches 0 from the right of 5 times 6 raised to the power of 0.2 minus 5 times c raised to the power of 0.2. And now we can determine this limit. Notice as c approaches 0, 5 times c to the 0.2 is going to approach 0, and this is not affected by c, and therefore this is equal to 5 times 6 raised to the power of 0.2. Remember, this is 2/10 or 1/5, so we could write this as 5 times 6 to the 1/5, or if we wanted to, 5 times the 5th root of 6. Or as a decimal approximation, this would be approximately 7.1548. And now that we've determined this definite integral is equal to 5 times the 5th root of 6, we also know it converges. And if we go back to the graph for a moment, because the function is non-negative on this interval, we've determined that the area of this unbounded region on the interval from 0 to 6 is equal to 5 times the 5th root of 6 square units. Let's take a look at a second example. This one looks very similar. Again, notice how the function is discontinuous or undefined at x equals 0. Again, if we want to, we can verify this by looking at the graph. Notice how we have infinite discontinuity at x equals 0. So once again, we'll write this as the limit as c approaches 0 from the right or positive side of the integral from c to 3. Again, let's write this as x to the power of negative 1.2. And now we'll integrate. So if we add 1 to the exponent, we would have x to the power of negative 0.2 divided by negative 0.2. To simplify this fraction here, we have divided by negative 2/10, or divided by negative 1/5, which is the same as multiplying by the reciprocal or multiplying by negative 5. So we can write this as the limit as c approaches 0 from the right of negative 5. And then because the exponent is negative, we'll move this to the denominator. So it'd be negative 5 divided by x to the power of positive 0.2. So now we'd have the limit as c approaches 0 from the right of negative 5 divided by 3 raised to the power of 0.2 minus negative 5 divided by c raised to the power of 0.2. Now we'll evaluate the limit. We'll notice how this first term is not affected by c. So we can write this as negative 5 divided by, this is 3 to the 2/10, or 3 to the 1/5 power, which would be the same as the 5th root of 3. Then we'll have minus, now notice how this fraction here, as c approaches 0, our denominator is getting smaller and smaller, and while our numerator is fixed at negative 5. Well, negative 5 divided by smaller and smaller positive values would approach negative infinity. So this approaches negative infinity, and therefore we have minus negative infinity, and therefore this limit is approaching positive infinity, which does not exist, and therefore our definite integral is divergent. So the definite integral is divergent and approaches positive infinity, which means if we go back to our graph for a moment, notice that once again, the function is non-negative on the interval from 0 to 3, but because this definite integral is divergent and approaches positive infinity, we cannot determine the area of this unbounded shaded region. It's approaching positive infinity. I hope you found this explanation helpful.